Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily, if it is your first time here, and I'm back. I took a really long break. A lot has happened in my life, like way too much, like could not even begin to get into it in this video. But you know, someday we'll get there. My hair looks insane, we're not talking about it, but I just wanted to do my makeup. And it's like late at night and I just like started dinner and it's like cooking right now, but I had to cut up onions and I started crying, so my eyes are really irritated right now. So my eyes are having a hard time, so this might be kind of interesting, and I literally cannot stop touching my hair because it's really bothering me. We're gonna get into it. We're just kind of gonna like, you know, I feel like I like don't even know what I'm doing. So I'm going to start by priming my eyes off camera, but I'm going to prime them with the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer. Yes, I'm still working on this. Look at that. So close to being done. So close to being done with that. And then I'm going to set them with my Hourglass powder from this quad from like last Christmas. Alright, so the eyelids are primed and set, and for eyeshadow today I'm going to be using a palette that I have yet to use, and it is the Violet Boss Violet Sunset palette. I just got this in either my Ipsy or my BoxyCharm. I honestly cannot remember which one, but it's really cute. Looks like this, like a nice sunset eye palette. But I've used Violet Boss shadows in the past and I have not always been the biggest fan of them, so I'm really hoping that this goes all right today, because imagine if my first video back in the eye look turns out like that'd be really funny. Okay, so I'm going to start by going in with this neutral pink called Sunset, and I'm gonna start applying that through my crease on an AOA Studio E141 brush. Okay, so now I'm going to go in with the matte purple called Lilac from this palette, and I'm going to be taking that on a Lavish Beauty tapered blending brush, and I'm going to start working that a little bit lower in my crease. I'm not obsessed with the way this is going so far. I feel like it's all just kind of blending into one thing on my eye. Like it's, I can't get it very refined. See, this is what, I just, I'm not a huge fan of Violet Boss eyeshadows. I'm sorry, I'm just not. I know people like are obsessed with them, I just, it's not terrible, but I didn't really, I'm not enjoying this. Okay, so next I'm going to take this like small fluffy brush that I got years ago on Amazon, like in an Amazon set, and I'm going to be taking the shade called Amber Sky, and I'm going to use that kind of on my outer lash line, and then I'm going to lightly bring it into my crease just to kind of get everything to mesh together. All right, and then I'm going to, on my finger, I'm actually gonna go in with the shade Champagne. I was going to take Violet Sunset, but I think I wanna do Champagne. It has like this really cool, like kind of like green sparkle in it, and I think that's gonna look cool with the purple in the crease, and then also tie in the color that we're going to be putting in our waterline. So I'm just gonna take some of that on my finger. and press that onto my lid. See, I really enjoy Violet Boss shimmers. Like, I find them to be very impactful. They're really easy to work with. It's just their mattes that, like, I don't know if I vibe with them. All right, and then I'm gonna go back in with Lilac and the Lavish Beauty Tapered Blending Brush and try to bring some of that purple back into my crease a little bit. I tend to always bring my shimmers really high into my crease. It's usually not intentional. I just have issues with that. And so they tend to like overpower the crease shade. And then I'm going to take Amber Sky again and kind of bring that back on the lash line. All right, I'm content with where that is at right now. It almost looks like the shimmer is like sinking into my eye. It's like not there anymore. Maybe I'll just blend it away. Maybe I should build up a little bit more. Yeah, I don't know if I'm loving this. I feel like my eyelids look really, really, really textured. Wait. Am I crazy? I don't know, maybe. I definitely am, but like, I don't know. So I'm gonna prime my face and I'm going to go in with my Touch and Soul Pretty Filter Icy Sherbet. I like to say sherbet. So that's how it's spelled. That's how it's technically pronounced, and it starts a little discourse with people because they're always like, you mean sherbet? And I'm like, no, I mean sherbet. And the stuff like smells so nice. It's so weird because it looks like it should be like kind of like a silicone-y primer, you know? But then you touch it and it's just like this like cool gel. You like rub it into your face and it like melts. And it's super interesting. So since I've been gone, my skin has like basically completely cleared up. I have two little friends up here, but we're not talking about them. So I have not really been wearing that much foundation recently. So today I'm just going to be going in with my Becca Light Shifter Dewing Tint. And I just realized I'm still not done priming my face. So I don't know why I'm trying to move on to foundation already. Two extra priming steps that I've been doing is I have the Tula Skincare Rose Glow and Get It Cooling and Brightening Eye Balm. And I like to put this on my under eyes. Just because for a while there, they were getting like super dry and it was making my concealer look weird and like crusty and flaky. And then I just so happened to get this in an Ipsy and I started using it and it was really nice. And it helped solve my issue just to kind of like have a moisturized layer underneath my eyes like before I put on my concealer and stuff. While we're at it, I'm just gonna throw on some Burt's Bees. And then on the high points of my face, on my sponge, I don't know what sponge this is, quite honestly, I'm going to be taking my Auric Beauty Glow Lust in the shade Selenite. And I'll take about this much, and I'll just start applying that to my cheekbones. And I'm probably only going to apply it here today only because normally I would take it like nose, center of my face, stuff like that, forehead. But the like base product that we're using today is very sheer and very glowy itself. So I don't feel like I'm going to need a ton of like extra added glow underneath my foundation. And I'm going to take some of the Dewing Tint on the back of my hand and I'm going to apply that with my sponge. So as you can see, that stuff is super, super, super glowy. Like I look a little bit Tin Man-y, but once we put our powders on and stuff, it looks super beautiful. So next I'm going to be taking my Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector and I'm going to take my Rare Beauty Concealer Brush and just use this to correct my under eyes. And then for my concealer today, I'm going to go in with my favorite concealer of all time, which is my e.l.f. HD Lifting Concealer. So I'm gonna go ahead and set that concealer down by taking my Beauty Bakery Flower Setting Powder. And I'm just really haven't been enjoying using that on my sponge. So that's what I'm going to do. I like really have been loading on the powder recently, honestly, if I'm being honest. Honestly, can I be honest? I'm going to set the rest of my face. I'm going to go in with my Hourglass Soft Light Finishing Powder. All right, so I've been doing my eyebrows a little bit differently. So I'm first going to just go in with some brow gel. This is my We Are Fluid Browsy Brow Gel. And I'm just gonna like gel my brows down basically. And then I want to wait till those completely set down, so we're going to come and fill them back in just a few minutes. So I'm going to go back to eyeshadow now, and I'm going to first take the shade Sunset and blend that out down here. And then next I'm going to go in with Amber Sky and just put that like on the outer third. Then on my LMR Cosmetics like flat brush like this, I'm going to take the shade Peach from this palette and use that to highlight the inner corners of my eyes. I'm going to put a little thin line of black liner on my top lash line, on both eyes, obviously. And I just do it like on the outer half of my eye. And then we're gonna do a little pop of color in the lash line. So I'm going to take my ColourPop Creme Gel Liner in the shade Marigold and put in my waterline. For my mascaras, I'm going to do them off camera, but on my top lashes, I'm going to be using my Tarte Maneater mascara, and then on my bottom lashes, I'm going to be using my Victoria Beckham Beauty Future Lash Mascara, which is a tubing mascara, which is why I like to use it on my bottom lashes, because it doesn't move, and I have really long bottom lashes, and it always smudges on me. All right, that is the eyes complete. So I'm going to move back to the eyebrows now. I'm still using my Anastasia Beverly Hills Dark Brown Brow Powder Duo. Except, I can't remember if I ever did this on my channel. I'm taking a little bit of a, like, it's a really small but flat and fluffy brush, and I just kind of like swirl it in my lighter of the powders, and then I just kind of use the brush to kind of, how many times am I gonna say kind of? I use the brush to push the brow hairs into place, and then it deposits some of that brow powder color too. And it just gives a really nice, like, natural, like, filled in look, which I feel like I need now that my hair is darker, but without making them look like insane filled in and still leaving them like really natural and fluffy, basically. And then for my bronzer today, this is a newer bronzer to me as well. This is the Hanalei Matte Bronzer. It's a really pretty color, and I've only used it one other time, but I did enjoy it that time that I used it. And I'm still using my ColourPop F21 brush for my bronzer. And then I'm going to highlight my face using the Vesca Beauty Stargaze Luminous Glow in the shade Moonlight. The only thing I've really changed about doing my highlighter is I really make sure that it's like super, super, super buffed into my skin, and take it up onto my forehead. Obviously, I must go down my nose. And then just a tiny, tiny bit on my chin and a little bit on my cupid's bow. For blush, this is also something I have not used yet. This is the Buxom Wanderlust Primer Infused Blush in the shade Mykonos. It's this really pretty kind of like peachy blush, and it has a really gorgeous shimmer running through it. And I think it's gonna look really pretty on the cheek. Seems to be a little bit powdery. That's all right. Just as I suspected, the most generic basic blush color is beautiful. I'm going to give my face a little spray with the Clean Skin Club Pineapple Glow Mist. This stuff smells really, really bad. And it's just sprayed me like directly in the eyeball. Whack. Oh, it's like clogged or something. Yeah, I'm not gonna use that actually. I'm going to go in with my Maven Beauty Rose Water Setting Spray, like literally directly in the eye, spray me. That stuff smells a lot better. Last but not least, we're going to do the lips. So I'm going to line them with the NYX, my eye's burning. I'm gonna line them with the NYX Lip Liner in the shade Pumpkin. And I have been smudging basically every lip liner out with my finger, just a little bit. And then I'm just going to top this with the Tower 28 Shine On Lip Jelly in the shade Almond. This is also new to my collection. And then very, very last, but most certainly not least, perhaps my favorite, hey, sup, My favorite part of my routine recently is I'm going to be using Freck, my fake freckles. Alright, this is the finished look. I really like the way it turned out. I feel super cute right now. This eyeshadow look ended up working out really, really well. And this blush is really pretty. I honestly cannot stop looking at this blush and this lip combo. I just really like my makeup. If you enjoyed this video, I hope you will give it a thumbs up and subscribe before you go. And hopefully I will see you in my next video. Bye!